Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to modify this printer 1390. If it's L1800, we can just do the drag chain this way. However, this is 1390. The carriage is longer than the L1800 because this one uses cartridges, so you cannot put the drag chain here. You have to put the drag chain in the back, which is actually the good news because it actually is better to put the drag chain behind the printed carriage. I call my system STMS, system that makes sense. And you can get it from bchtechnology.com. This tubing is 8 strands, and we only need 5 of them, so we'll tear off 3 of those. Then we need these 5 go with 2 C3 tubes, and the 3 tubes are for the white dampers. Basically, you get 7 tubes go into the drag chain. There are 2 C3 tubes, and there's strands of 5 C2 tubes altogether, and your end result look like a shrimp or angry dragon. Then I put this red booster plate on the printed carriage. It's necessary to have a booster plate because the drag chain is higher than the printed carriage. For the drag chain, you can directly screw it on the rail, and then in the middle you want to have a clip so you can stabilize the drag chain on the rail. This green thing is called a printed management assembly, PMA. And see 3 tubes. One goes to the left. It doesn't matter which one goes to the left. And one goes to the right. And underneath is the white ink tank, which balance the pressure when you're printing. Then for the 5 C2 tubes, those 4 of those go to dampers. Then the 2 C3 tubes coming out from the management assembly goes to the white damper. The C2 tubes, we have 5 lines. 4 of them do the color damper, and one of them is the maintenance tube that goes to the maintenance tank. And this smaller tank is the maintenance tank. So we connect that line to this tank. And the 2 big tubes coming out from that smaller tank, they are maintenance dampers. So you have 4 big tubes. 2 on the left is the white ink. 2 on the right is the maintenance. Now I connect to the other side, the 4 tubes to the color tank, and one tube goes to the maintenance tank. I'm gonna put the links to different products I use in this video in the description. You can expand it and check them out. There are more details on the webpage. So for the maintenance tank, basically just a tube goes to the middle jar, and the 2 tubes go to the last jar will be the white. The white ink will have a mixer, or called a stirrer. You don't want those tubes touch the very bottom of the bottle. You want them hanging up a little bit so it doesn't suck all the condensation underneath. So we put the stirrer on, and then screw the stirrer on the top of the cap. The beauty about this setup is whenever you change the white ink, you can just lift up the cap and change the whole bottle. Again, I just cut it short and leave a half inch above the bottom of the bottle. I have to mention this system is 24 volts, which is the most system run on. So just check your voltage before you purchase this mixer. Now I wire the tube through the pump. It really doesn't matter which direction the pump goes as long as it's circulating. Oh, this gray box is controller. As long as you can find a 24 volts consistent power source, you can use this one to drive your stir and pump at the same time. And it's pre-programmed. So basically it is a management system by itself. This printer was designed that whenever you turn the printer on, the stirrers run permanently, just running, create noises. So just put that power into this gray box, and then let this gray box manage it. You prolong the lifetime of your steer and the pump. Also, it's a lot less noisy. And I do have another video show you how to install that box in this tank. If you use it almost every day or every other day, just use distilled water. And if you like do it in a couple days, and you can use capping or diluted water solution. You might find that I put that red thing underneath. That's an organizer, so you get three bottles: white ink, maintenance, and waste tank. Okay, if we did everything correctly, when we turn the printer on, you should see the white ink goes through the secondary tank and then get returned to the bottle. Perfect. You might notice not only the ink fill the secondary tank, and also see the lines goes to the damper. It also fill the lines to the damper, and that's a good sign. Okay, let's fill up the maintenance tank. So we just take the damper out and use a syringe, and we suck until we see the damper is filled with water. And then we fill up color tanks. And for each damper, we suck ink until the damper is full. For the white, it should be half full. It's automatic, always half full. So if you fill up the whole damper, half of the ink will go out. Anyway, but when I prime it, I just make it full because I'm going to do a cleaning really soon. Okay, now it's magic time. Okay, take a 5 mL syringe. Don't use 10 mL, use 5. And see the bottom black rubber? Slowly pull until the bottom of the black rubber hits the 2 mL mark. Then count to 5. Then draw another ring and make that ring match to 2. And then draw another ring. And until your rubber pass the 2 mL mark, and hold for 10 seconds. And then release. Okay, now I'm going to run a cleaning, but when I'm doing that, let me explain to you. You want to pull it slowly, but you should feel resistance. And if you don't feel resistance, that's how you have a bad seal between your capping station and the printhead. However, if you feel total resistance, that means your capping station is clogged. You have to clean your capping station. Of course, I have other videos show you how to service the capping station. Okay, now do a cleaning from sending a command through your computer. And when you finish cleaning, it's ready to print. Okay, now it's printing time. Congratulations, you just turned your 1390 to a beast. I want to mention, when I print, I usually do a cleaning every 4 designs or every 4 pages. The reason is not it's clogged. The reason is I want to save the printhead from drying. I have another video about the color rotation, and please watch that video. Okay, we finished the job, and we don't clean it at the end of the day. We clean it up right after we finish the job. So if I have a couple jobs together, and do it together, just do one printing time. Okay, so now we pull off the white dampers. We put it in the holding box. Now we prime water dampers again and install the damper in the white ink slot. Now we pick up the waste tube and the same thing, prime it. Slowly draw until the bottom of the black seal touch the 2 mL. Then pull another ring, count to 5, pull another ring, count to 5, and then count to 10 and release. When you do this, the printhead has to park at the capping station naturally. By naturally, I mean turn it on, okay? So you might guess, afterwards, we'll do a cleaning. After cleaning, we're going to print a white strip. In the RIP software, when we go print, we're not going to select the white plus color. And when you do not select it, I print white as white, then followed by a color. And we'll make sure that there's no white coming out anymore and that the water is completely replaced the white. Also, we want to make sure that there's no clog. So you can see we got a great amount of water coming out. The white is totally flushed out from the printhead. This is when you select the color plus white, then I print the white first, then now it prints color. Okay, I like to print both of them because I want to make sure there's no clog in the color. Again, you do the maintenance right after your job, not end of the day. Okay, for example, your working day may be end up at 5 o'clock, but at 5 o'clock, your daycare called. You forgot to pick up your kids. Now you have to select between your kids and more importantly, your DTF printer. I know for every DTF owners, they're going to select the important thing, okay? Anyway, you get my points. So now we do the shoe shine. You probably know 100 times how to do shoe shine. And after the shoe shine, you want to keep the towel there so the printhead can be moist. Now we're going to use this TMS machine and to clean up the cabin station. Okay, every time you finish job, clean the cabin station. So we got just a milk jar and we'll put the other end of the TMS in there. We connect the waste tube to the input of the TMS. Basically, the TMS sucks ink from the cabin station. We're going to turn the TMS on and now we start squirting water on the cabin station. I usually use half a bottle, and every time you need to use at least half a bottle. Okay, don't just think it looks clear, just use half a bottle every time. If you damage a printhead, it's going to cost you a printhead. If you damage a cabin station, it's going to cost you a printhead and a cabin station. And after that, you want to fill the cabin station with water as much as possible. Okay, completely filled it. Then you move the printhead on the cabin station and turn the printer on. Just let it leave like that. You're all set. People ask me, do I need to do this every day? No, you don't need to do this every day. Your printhead is completely clean. There's no white ink in the printhead. You don't need to maintain it every day. But you do need to maintain it every time you finish your job. Okay, not every day, every time you finish your job. Okay, just let it sit there. And I'm going to show you the second day when I come back and then how easy for me to start a job. Okay, if you finish a job correctly, it's really easy. And the second day I come back and I just put a white damper in and I pull off the waste tube, remember, do the 5, 5, and then 10 seconds. And after sucking it, I just do a head cleaning. I just go to my computer, send a cleaning command, and the printer should ready to go. Okay, move the film forward a little bit. Just skip that ugly water spill. Again, if you do this way and do this modification, you do not need to maintain your printer every day. I have another video that I showed you. I ignored my printer for 14 days, 2 weeks. No maintenance in 2 weeks. And come back and as good as new. Okay, all the tools are at my webpage, bchtechnologies.com. Please visit us or online or locally. At Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers. Oh, look at that white.